Hello, hello, welcome everyone to the Sunday stream where we analyze your games. Hello. I see many of you in the chat getting excited already. Hello, hello. Somebody got a board, second-hand Shogi board table, big one, $50. Well, question is how new that board was, Kent. I assume the one that you bought was better quality, but maybe he was more lucky in that case. Well, too late, yeah. Kifu is a game indeed. Kifu basically means we're gonna go over your Kifu, your games. We're gonna look at them, we're gonna analyze them, we might roast them if it's particularly bad, but all in order to improve at Shogi, yeah? I'm new in the server, welcome. Made myself a Lee Shogi account. Only did puzzles. Yeah, that's a good start. First you need to know how to capture the king after all, right? And then you can figure out all the strategies and tactics later. That's a good start. Hello, the 35k pilot, welcome. I'll call you pilot, that's shorter. Are we allowed to submit games played with bots? I think it's okay. Yeah, Contetti, we don't have a particular rule about that, but sure. All right. Now let's see on our Kifu. Oh my gosh, my keyboard has so much dust. Oh my god. So much dust. Now that I notice, I'm quite uncomfortable with it. All right, cleaned a little. We have CEO game. Let's download it. We will have a call for YouTube. Okay, we're gonna put it on YouTube then. Todd of Sky, which is not on YouTube. Then we have Contetti Gotte and Eon Grey livestream, as well as Lily Lion Main. Oh. Long time no see. Valorant Eddie variant. And if you guys have more, please upload it. I don't know if we will manage everything, but we're gonna do as much as possible, yeah? Hopefully we're gonna learn from it. So Sea of Plate handicap game, apparently. This is my freestyle game against Mifa. My freestyle is pretty bad, so he was practicing freestyle game with me. All right. Is it handicap? No, it's just fixed black. All right. Call, let's download at least three of them, and Toad. And see if we'll be sent. Let's jump right to it. The 81 Dodger, because I just need to know which side are you playing, yeah? Like, which side should I concentrate on? So if you played it on Lee Shogi, it should be your Lee Shogi name. If you played it on 81 Dojo, you can of course add your Twitch name if it's different in the bracket or something if you want me to notice, but I usually can figure it out. Well, apparently this is this game, Mifa. It ends like this. Yeah. Click. So the freestyle is actually a word in Japanese that's called Rikisen. It just translated like that. Rikisen means more like a power battle. That means that you're out of the opening line and you're gonna play something out of your creativity. I wonder if this is the proper way you used it. So far, I see. So Mifa is playing some weird opening that will end up being freestyle. Yeah, this is the bishop head pawn. It's quite a tricky one. You send the game you asked Mifa to that Mifa asked you to send. He said that he saw someone play like this against him. All right. Today I finally truly beat Mifa with bishop drop handicap. Congratulations, Kent. It's called bishop down handicap, by the way, not drop. What's the idea of pound 6-6? Well, it could indicate that we're going for Yagura Gangi or swinging rook strategy. Yeah, I would agree. Maybe it's a little bit too early, but we would have to ask C of what exactly he had in mind. But yeah, it seems like maybe he's going to swing that rook? No. Gangi, then. I would imagine. All right. So Mifa is playing something out of Joseki. Yeah, normally you would activate your bishop, you would activate your rook, or swing it and activate it. This gold general would rather stay with the king as a defender, but this is completely Rikisen, right? The freestyle battle. So in those type of games, what you want to do is not just play moves because you play moves. You want to consider what the what's the opponent's intention. You want to consider what's their shape. Yeah, where's the new weakness? Because the castles that we know, we already know the weakness, right? We know, oh, Yagura is weak from the side. Mino is weak from the front or the ear. But something like this, where is the weakness here? Yeah, clearly there's one weakness here. And eventually there might be a weakness here as well. So this is something we would like to look for. Also the fact that he's using the gold to attack, maybe we would like to exchange it for a silver. Maybe we would like to go here, here and like exchange it quickly. I would consider this, yeah. But here we're going for slow development. Here we push this pawn. Again, I would try to maybe exchange those two pieces like this. But this, I thought maybe you're going like this. And yet you pushed both of the pawns. So now I'm expecting this rook move to make a put a pressure on the gold, yeah? So that's what I'm kind of reading from your moves. I don't know what you had exactly on your mind playing those moves, see of. I just see this gold as being a target. You told you exactly the same thing? Oh. How do you know that 2-3 is a weakness? Well, if you close your eyes and imagine that this pawn is in hand, this would be very painful for the bishop, right? Or like if you had a gold or something. It's a weakness. It's a weakness. It's an undefended spot. It's a well-known spot that you would target in Shogi. Yeah, the fact that pawn pushed is the pawn drop won't necessarily work, but 3 steps later, maybe we can abuse the bishop. The thing is, the reason why we put gold here in the first place is that once this bishop is gone, a pawn drop is possible, yeah, behind it. And it kind of puts a pressure on the knight, sometimes captures it, often captures the knight. So it's just a well-known spot. Yeah, so the fact that the silver cannot move sideways determines this to be a weakness, kind of. Yeah, so it's just like the basics of static rook. It's good to know. All right, so knight jump. Yeah, so this is like the basic shape, but this means that you don't have a way to engage. Because now this gold is kind of protecting this knight movement, right? So unless you want a castle here and then move there, kind of feels like a missed chance, yeah? You could expose that the fact that enemy had a gold here going for a slow game. Okay. What we gonna do? What's the plan, Siof? What's the plan? We need to have a... Okay, I see you're going pretty freestyle yourself. Speaking of freestyle, I would consider moves like this to like break the opponent's good shape, for example. Because this is a weak, for example, yeah. Yeah, Lance. For example, this is a weakness now, yeah? We could consider something like this. The fact that the gold is up, meaning he's more vulnerable for the bishop draw, for example, yeah? We need to be more creative here. The other thing is, well, this bishop here isn't really working well because there are two pawns. Maybe less aggressive would be go here and then here. This is a well-known line as well. Go away, fly. I know I ate sorbet before, I know, and my face is sweet probably, but go away. Yeah, so look at your pieces, think, what's your objective? See if, that's my question for you first. What was your objective? So far, I don't know if Cf is here, actually. Was he? Yeah, I swear he was, but... Cf should be here. So I want you to answer like the question, what was your plan? So this type of pawn pushes determine that it's hard to engage. Just think. Now Mifa is going for an engagement. And your bishop is not very active, yeah? Unforge. No! That's a strategy. You need more of detailed plan. Like, for example, they put their rook here, meaning their powerful attack will come from here. So maybe I put my king here away from it. Or I put my camp in the balance position, so then I can exchange the rooks and I can threaten this bishop. You need plan like this, yeah? Something more concrete. Like I push this pawn in order to develop this bishop, put a pressure on the gold, yeah? Especially in freestyle. Yeah, so here I want you to notice this move that you made is a pass. Because we could have played a different move. We have this position. And now compare it to this one. What's the difference? Well, we had one more move played. Can you see the difference? Unless your plan was to wait. Yeah, you burn a move. And it's fine, but this is why I'm asking you. Was it intentional or did you just lose the move on purpose? Yeah? Atempolos, yes. Knights like this usually are a bad idea. Because look at this situation, yeah? You've determined that this knight will stay here until end of the game. The opponent has a knight in hand. They can use it anywhere they see fit. They can wait. They can keep for the end game. They can fork some pieces. The fact that you've already determined this knight's position mean that you lose some cool moves in the future, yeah? So also let's consider, where are you fighting? Where is the enemy king? There, right? Where is the move that you're making? Here. What does it indicate? That the action is going to happen here. Whose king is closer to that fighting area? Oh, your king. So that indicates it's a bad flow of the game, yeah? That indicates you are in danger. If you don't have two moves to spend in your opponent's area. Unless, of course, you have some good moves and so on. Maybe you'll be able to promote the bishop or something. But this, again, looks kind of like a pass, yeah? Now Mifa can play a move that's threatening something. Now he can play again another move that's threatening something. And he achieved a big goal, yeah? A token. What did we achieve? Oh, we just put a lens here for nothing. Yes, look at the difference of those two lenses and this pawn promotion. This pawn versus this pawn. This pawn, my dear friend, is 1, 2, 3 steps away from your king. This pawn that isn't even talking would need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 moves. Now it's blocked by the lance, so probably 2 more. So notice how much more impactful this pawn drop is compared to this. You both drop the lance, you both drop the pawn. Your king is just too close, yeah? How many games are needed to get rating? 5 rated games. They have to specifically be rated ones. A pawn should be pushed on the opponent's kind flank, king flank. If you can, yeah, but we can feel that we don't have any piece to support this kind of push. We don't have a pawn currently in hand as well. If we consider this position, yeah. With the lance, we cannot do match against that king yet. Considering our piece's position, maybe, as I mentioned, this bishop line would be nice to have, like a pawn push of some sorts. But yeah, it's double defended, so... Basically, the choices we made, if we had this knight in hand, maybe we could have considered something like this, yeah? And if this was a knight, we had a nice attack. But we already invested it here, so that's not a possibility. Maybe if we had one more move, if we didn't mess it up before, maybe we could have inputted this move before to put more pressure. Maybe played another move, you know? Maybe here we could have put pressure on the gold just to defend a little bit more now that we have double protection here. But yeah, anyway, this knight, in the, you know, robbed us from our options a little bit. And Mifa is the one that has all the pieces, 4 pieces in attack, yeah, meaning it's a very strong attack. We have currently none. 0. Yeah, I don't know what Sandy could have done better, but that's the situation. Yeah, I used the lance. Alright, so 4-piece attack. So yeah, I wanted you to notice that difference, and this is why it feels a little bit bad. Does it block the rook or it doesn't? It doesn't, right? It's just a pawn that you give away. Do we have time to play this move? I don't think we have time for this, but yeah, sure. We're trying to activate all the pieces. It would be nice if we done it like 5 moves ago. Now, even if we promote a piece here, it's 1, 2, 3 moves away from the king. This guy is already 2 moves away from the king. Now we block all the pieces. This one is a little bit more aggressive because it activates the rook. This one blocks both of them, yeah? 1, 2, 3. 1. I assume we're gonna promote, but... He lost a gold, there is a dragon. Yeah. Everything is dead, yeah. Yep. Yep. Please resign if you see that you're losing. Yeah, don't ever play illegal move. It's a bad habit to have. So yeah, you didn't have a good plan, I believe. You having, I know that C of, what's your rating, C of? You were 4Q, yeah? I don't wanna like scold you too much, but the main problem here, which comes, you know, from lack of experience, naturally, you will learn those things. But you didn't have a long-term strategy. You say, oh, I play Subway Rook. But that just playing Subway Rook is not a win condition. Yeah, you have to answer the question, what's my win condition? And I recommended you maybe bishop exchange. Yeah, would be nice to put a pressure on the opponent's rook. Yeah. Maybe putting more pressure on the gold was a good idea in the opening. So especially in free game, Where there's no joseki and you have no good habits, you don't know where to look, you have to spend more time thinking about those strategical objectives. Until the last move. Yeah, but that's past the last move, CEO. That's definitely past that move. Yeah, so it's not an easy answer, but I hope you will understand now, yeah, the value of the token, the speed of the enemy, the closeness of your king to the enemy engagement. That was very important in this game, so maybe you can use it in the next one, yeah? Thank you for sending the Kifu, yeah? Why does the bishop exchange put pressure on the rook? Well, let's say this happens, and we immediately have a bishop drop here, right? We can make a horse, and it's nice. While our camp is pretty secure against bishop drops. So us just having that advantage of the bishop would be huge, I believe. And white would like to continue attacking, but they have to continue looking at the holes in their defense. And the holes are because this gold is here. So that's my logic. Actually, Abigail is pretty tricky, I think. It's not easy to break through, yeah, but this gold here is quite unusual as well. It's quite a pressure on the enemy Migi Gyoku here. It's something we should have considered as well. All right, next. Who was next? I think it was Ko. Oh, no, Ko was for YouTube. All right. Toad, you will be next. Each time Goston and I get paired on their ladder, I try a different response to his opposing rook strategy, trying to find some way to stop his attack and defend my king without heavy material loss. Okay. We're gonna see how it went then. Just an equal. Hi, Toad. Oh, and by the way, Abigail, thank you for resubscribing. Yeah, I saw it, but I forgot to say it out loud. Thank you so much. So we have double swinging rook. Now the question is, which castle would you prefer? Quite interesting. I wonder if the rooks should be floating or not in this particular strategy. Because your opponent might want to go for quick attack and you want to go for solid play. So like, we would have to be careful about moves like this, right? But we're gonna see. No, this helps them. Oh yeah, this one also, but maybe the rook can go here, so it doesn't force them to go back. Even if it moved, force them to go back, it's not a big of a deal. They can move the bishop here and push this pawn. So your main objective would be to finish the anagoma. Currently this pawn is under attack. You have two ways of defending it, bishop, silver or knight. I think you want to keep the defense here, so maybe that's why you chose this. Which is fine in that case. We are going aggressive here. Yet our anaguma is not finished. And you are looking toward this square. So if we take, go here, your idea is to go here. Take. Because your gold is here, you defend all the rook drops. The bishop is protecting this square. I think it's pretty good. If we go here, defend the lance, this bishop drop happens. If we go here, well, the lance drops. I think it's a nice idea. Therefore, we can arrive at the conclusion that this move by your opponent was a little bit dubious. Or when you moved here, going back was correct. I mean, going for Senjte technically it benefits white, right? So it could be considerable. And here we make a dent in their castle. And usually what you would like to do is now expose this pin on the king and bring the knight here. If they defend with a pawn, you can bring the silver here. Or still jump with the knight, silver goes, and then, you know, you can take it. Basically, this silver being here is like weakness of Yagura. Knight against silver is nice, but yeah, you notice that it's not as easy because silver moving would attack the knight, so it all depends on the timing. The other move would be pawn drop. You have a nice vanguarded pawn in front of the king, but yet no follow-up. So we are arriving at the same problem. How do we deal with this pawn? Okay. Solution is the same. But now they changed their move, so what would you do? So this shape isn't good. I played it in the past. It's not gonna be good. I would drop the pawn and then take this pawn for free. Thank you for the following, Versif. The idea here is I will be able to eat this pawn next and you're in Fugire. No pawns, yeah. So, yeah. Yeah, what you gonna do now? They defended it. You went too lightly. Light attack, light defense, yeah? So it was important maybe to defend here. This pawn is very important now. This pawn exchange, you shouldn't worry too much. The castle you wanna do is put the gold here, have double defend on this square. It should be fine. And now you have a nice vanguard pawn here. Not really vanguard pawn, like extended pawn, let's call it. But here, yeah, it's gone. It's gone. This bishop still have a square to go to. Also, the moment you go here, maybe they can push this pawn. You take, take, take. Yeah, maybe too scary with the king being here. Yeah. So you went down, yeah? Not here. This would be more standard. Here, maybe because you're feeling that the rook exchange is coming in. Maybe. We're going for solid plan, but now we're pushed back. Yeah, having the pawn in hand, yeah, it's quite troublesome. And now I would be eager to take pawn, but then you have this, then you go here. It's not... I mean, it is kind of helpless, not gonna lie. Oh! 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 A fight started. That should benefit you, because without pawns you were looking for some way to attack. Okay, Toad, what's the most important piece in this position? For you. What's perhaps the two most important pieces for you? One, this horse for the attack. Two, those two servers in defense. Those two generals in defense. What's the most important piece for the enemy? Well, all those pieces are doing something. Perhaps the rook would be an attacker, but currently is doing nothing. Maybe this rook in hand is quite important for them. But here you're saying this rook is more important than this silver. And clearly, even though it's a rook and we say, oh, the rook is so much stronger than the silver is much more important because it does something. It keeps connection, keeps your king safe. The enemy rook is doing nothing here. But yeah, the problem you have is if you take it, they have the rook drop, right? So this is where our main problem arrives at, but this is why your opponent move was so good. In that case, maybe, yeah, maybe we are forced to do stuff like this. But you see, yeah. Quite painful. Our castle now disappeared. Our king was dragged out. And you don't want to see the king being dragged out like this when your king, when your opponent have a rook in hand, right? Yeah. Your rook their side, yeah. Yeah. Unfortunate, yeah. You could try to promote if they drop a silver, you go here and then you can exchange two pieces for one. But yeah, I think it might be quite helpless. Like, I can imagine rook drop taking here and check here. I don't think it's enough. So maybe interesting. Here you're taking this, king this, take. If they drop the rook, we say I care about this gold more than the other, and we are one general down, right? And maybe then we can drop the lance. Then they go here, then we take this. And the fight continues. Question mark. What's the other option? Quite in disadvantage still, I feel. Yeah, because we're missing one general, yeah? So good play from your opponent, I think. But yeah, this is why, you know, this gold being here was hanging, it was in the bad spot, and this is what your opponent used against you. It's good, but you're losing the gold in this variation. In this variation, yeah? If we calculate, we have three generals. We normally have four, right? Our opponent has five. So even though we both have two big pieces, it's equal, we are losing material still. And this is why Toad is a little bit worse off. On top of which, we have no good attack on this king, so we cannot fight back on the piece disadvantage. And that's the most painful thing here. Even if we drop the bishop, we cannot really promote it, right? Because then this gold will die. So it's quite helpless. And this is why around here Toad is already losing. Yeah, without pawns, without having ability to attack. Every pawn matters in the opening, let me say that. And it might seem like you may do something. You're still able to do something, but slowly they're gonna get to you. It's unavoidable. It's a checkmate, yeah? So let's look where it went bad, around here, yeah? When you put a pawn like this, you have to be sure that you're able to defend it. Else you shouldn't put it at all. You should have played another move. Yeah, silver up, perhaps. So this silver is pretty good usually. It opposes this silver here, yeah? Finish the castle would be another move. Yeah, even if you played this, even if they dropped a pawn, you exchange the pawn, you're happy, you just finish your castle. Yes, they can exchange this pawn, who cares, yeah? Maybe here in this case. Finish your castle, yeah, maybe here. They will finish, you finish. And now we can do whatever you want, yeah? Which is difficult, yeah? You need to find some way to attack. But you're not behind on pawns. That pawn feels heavy. It's one of those pawns that you would like to have, But it's like this risky investment. And turns out that it was taken for free. It's the worst thing that can happen. So either we protect it or don't drop it all. Yeah. We say that in endgame, material doesn't matter. In the opening, every pawn matters. So please remember that. If you remember what you felt during the game, please remember this position. And you're like, I'm out of pawns. What can I do? Nothing. Because you cannot win without pawns. It's a proverb. You cannot win without pawns. Funashi kachinashi. Yeah? No pawn, no win. It's a proverb. Please remember the thought. All right, next uranium pawn. I don't wanna get cancer. No, thank you very much. I mean, Anaguma is playable, it's just that, yeah. The opening of the middle game wasn't good. All right, Conteti, next. Conteti is saying, I'm still struggling to get to 8Q on other sites, but was happy that I managed to get to 7Q on Shogi Quest at 4 a.m. in the night. Okay. It's fine. I don't yet grasp the right time to start castling or when to continue attacking without overcastling. Okay. Computer sensei said that I was winning since move 39, but then it took me 30 moves. It's good. It's okay. I mean, Shogi is a slow game. Maybe there was faster attack. Okay, we're gonna check it. I didn't consciously use any endgame techniques here. Okay, so we're gonna point out some endgame techniques. I'm gonna quickly log in, yeah. Because I prefer to have my own board. All right. There is no invincible castle against Mifa. There is no invincible castle dot. Sleep, please. Chen, go to sleep. Do we know which is somebody is challenging me? No, thank you. Conteti, but we don't. Do we know 2Q? Conteti is on top. All right. So we're gonna flip it. Boop. So that we're Conteti, guys. We're Conteti. So move, was it 48, I believe? That had interesting situation. 39, all right. Okay, Kakutori. So here is when you want a castle in general. You move silver once, and then you move the king. Because anything else, this is too aggressive already, yeah? You could consider pushing this pawn, defending a little bit more. But going here blocks your rook temporarily, looks scary. And yeah, you know he will push this pawn, so you want to be ready. All right. Yeah, this is a weird position. You want to keep your rook open in case something happens. You continue the pressure, yeah? You want to keep the silver here in case you want to put it here and here. You want to be a little bit more flexible. This is why they often play this move, to have three options. Even if you want to go bogging, play it maybe once, then look. Always look what your opponent does. Yeah, maybe you want to play this move. You want to oppose the central rook. Maybe you want to play this. Yeah, consider different moves. This is like saying, I'm going for bogging, what you gonna do? Well, he can see that you're going for bogging, he will be ready. So we have a small problem now. If we even try to castle, they will start attacking. So this is why we're kind of stuck here. And we have no options but to attack. And the problem with this king is that it's really close to the enemy attack. It might be a little bit scary. But let's continue, yeah? Okay, we forced him to go back in that case. Well, in that case, we should be careful about, like, the rook move, yeah? Especially now when our silver is hanging, we should be careful about this move. Ay, 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 ay. I mean, this pawn, you know, takes, bishop can still go back, so it's not too much of a big deal. Pawn takes, yeah, this silver going in is a little bit more scary, actually. Okay. So we're going aggressive. Taking the gold, taking the pawn, promoting the rook, right? Can promote the rook, get a dragon. This is also a good move. Problem is they will probably push this pawn, yeah? So, but yeah, it's a chance to get a dragon. Oh my gosh, they moved here. So they have to run to the side, yeah? They have to go somewhere else with that. Maybe then you promote. Yeah, but then the bishop escapes, yeah? Maybe then you can make a dragon. Maybe that's good as well. You've paralyze their pieces. So I guess that isn't the worst. Isn't the worst? Looks kind of heavy, depending on the situation. They could ignore it, but yeah, maybe it's good. Yeah, this is simplified castle. This is like modern Shogi. You want a castle, then start running at your opponent like a madman. We take the rook. All right, that's good. So this is where we started succeeding, right? We got a huge advantage. So whatever you did okay this time. This is great job. You sabaki your rook, yeah? You have a dragon they don't have. You have a rook, you have two rooks. They have only silver. So great job here, and now you should win from here. Now the question is, how do we win actually? Well, I said you have piece advantage, but that's considering the fact that you activate all of your pieces. You can take those two pieces if you can as well, but the bishop activation will be a big thing here. Yeah, something like this, Jen. Okay, taking the knight is good. Dropping the knight. Like, we could consider taking the other lands, activating the bishop here, because the bishop, you know, you have a knight drop here. Pretty nice, but maybe you will allow them to activate their bishop. Or maybe the knight is better. Problem with the knight is maybe they could just run, but then you drop the rook. Then you take it, drop the god. So depending on the situation, when you have a huge advantage, you actually want to slow down. You wanna, I'm gonna use this word, but you wanna be sadistic to a certain degree. If you take this pawn, what they gonna do? What can they do? Or maybe drop a pawn, drop the knight, then you run away. But they cannot really break your king's defenses, right? So once you return that move, it's like, you don't have enough pieces to attack my king. So paradoxically, we want to go aggressive, but going non-aggressive is better. So this is something that beginners need to learn. This means maybe I'm going to give them more pieces in hand, yeah? I'm going to take the bishop, they take. Now they have a gold, silver, silver knight, four pieces. Yeah, on top of this, they will probably promote this pawn. Make a chip on your castle. Or go there, this is also a good move. That's scary, little bit. That's scary, little bit. No, 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 no. Isn't this scary? Isn't this move a little bit scary? Um, I mean, if you go here, it's a checkmate, right? If you go here, you know, bishop check is quite something we have to be careful about. So maybe you go here. Just a look at it, your king is blocking your bishop, but I think you're surviving. I think, you know, they cannot take it here. They cannot take it here. They will have to take it here. Maybe the knight will die. So maybe it's fine. But like just inputting this move, then taking, kind of brings breaks up your castle a little bit, yeah? Okay, they're just defending, just attacking. You already know that this bishop might come here, right? You already know that. So you know that this bishop is very mobile. And I'm still unhappy because your bishop is not active, yeah? Okay. Okay, Contetti. Think again. Think again. Which piece do we take in this position? Which piece do we take? Yeah, definitely you should take it. Always read three moves ahead, no? Not only, oh, I'm gonna threaten the bishop. Well, your opponent will see that their bishop is under attack. They will try to escape. Then what will you do? Yeah, those three questions, three moves you have to ask yourself. Doesn't work. So which move is better here? Yeah, this guy is protected by 1, 2, 3 pieces. This guy is protected by 1. So this is 3. This guy is actually a 3 piece. Then you take, take. And you got 2 gold for 1 silver. Pretty good deal for me. And you can say, oh yeah, they're gonna drop another piece. But you have piece advantage. If you continue adding pieces, you will eventually run out of pieces, right? Because that's how peace advantage works. Just continue the pressure, continue the pressure. The knight. Or even bishop here. Force them to drop everything. And then, you know, you can win slowly. Your king is safe. Look at this stupid position. It's kind of stupid. Thank you, Honeymint. Look at this. The only active 2 pieces are those ones. Those silver do nothing. It seems like your enemy has a lot of pieces. They do nothing. Your king? He's on vacation. He can run anywhere he wants. And this is this kind of position you want to arrive at when you have peace advantage. Let them shoot all the ammo. And then look how many pieces you have in hand. Yeah. You can be evil. You can be like, I'm gonna make a token. What you gonna do? Well, hey, nothing. Just make a token and you win. Isn't this beautiful and simple? Isn't it? Also, you probably have a mate here. Like this, but... to make it even more... But yeah, it kind of is against my point. I wanted to show you can win slowly. But probably because your piece advantage is so huge. You can win like this. Yeah, and that's because 2 dragons are stronger than 2 generals. Be evil, yes. Make your opponent cry. That's the advice I heard when I was in Kishu. Be so evil, your opponents cry. If you're winning, yeah? Just destroy their hopes for the future. I know it sounds evil, but this is how you should win in Shogi. If you go lightly, they will take your pieces and reuse it against you. Don't give them your pieces. Take the 3 pieces. Take it all. Yeah, so here we also can take 2 generals for 1. That's a good exchange. But it gives them a rook. Yeah, our king is fine. Our king is fine. Maybe pawn drop is something we should like read out carefully. Generally, we should be fine. Yeah, But we have to read this, yeah, before doing it. So you went here. Yeah, that's great. My question is, what if they take it with the silver? No, Lily, you cannot brute force life. There are different rules in life, unfortunately. Because life is many shogi games in a row. Even if you win one, they will learn from it and the next one won't be this easy. So yeah, a good move would be to go here, but in this particular moment, maybe your king would be unsafe. So maybe dropping the knight first was a better idea. Like, things like this we should consider, basically, yeah? But yeah, good job there. What was your other question? Let me double check. You didn't subconsciously... You did endgame techniques. My friend. This is an endgame technique. This is what we talked about on Thursday. Do you guys know the Edgelord? Edgelord. You guys know the guy with a big head, big ears? The Edgelord is the castle weakness. What is the castle weakness here? The ear. So you're using the high level endgame technique here. You're attacking the ear of the castle. That's really, really good. What you're attacking? Threatening with a night drop, right? It's amazing. Then you sacrifice your dragon. Beautiful. Well done. Very beautiful endgame. But yeah, I want you to notice, yeah, you had such huge advantage that it didn't matter. But the king is a little bit in the open, yeah? So if we have huge advantage, maybe we would like to avoid having it. So maybe returning a move a little bit, forcing your opponent to overplay might be an option. Yeah, well done. You didn't play any defensive moves after the mid-game started, so that's good. Apart from that one moment. Yeah, not always we have to be aggressive. Alright, thanks, Condetti. Once you get the advantage, you decide what happens in the game, yeah? Alright, Eon next. Eon says, I lost several games last week, but I feel the most embarrassed by this one. So I thought my mistakes might make some good content for the stream. Alright, let's take a look. Ion got there. I went for a nice walk today. It's quite hot. Really, really nice walk. Guys, do you also go on Sunday walk? Not sitting in front of the virtual shogi board the whole day? It's important, yeah, to walk a little bit. Hello, Yellow. Thank you for sending. Let's take a look, yeah? When you see something like this, you swing your rook immediately. Does it count if my king walks across? No, it doesn't. It has to be your own legs. You see, the bishop exchange 4-5 rook works well. Because by taking this bishop and then moving the silver twice, that's 3 moves. If you go this way, 1, 2, so it's 1, 2, 3, that's also 3 moves. I guess it doesn't matter. But basically, I would recommend moving the rook first, maybe. If they push, then moving here. I think it doesn't matter in the end, right? Because he took it, yeah? didn't have to take it. Maybe it's the same. You went for a nice walk outside earlier today to walk on Sundays? Nice, really. Good, good. Get some vitamin D. Yeah, as long as you don't walk in the night. You walked a Shogi meetup today. Oh, that's the best type of walk. Oh, you're gonna listen while walking. Whoa, I didn't consider this option. Ooh, Contetti, you're playing good moves today. This is how we speak in Japanese. You don't say, what a great choice. Now you're saying, ooh, that's a great move. Yeah, you know when somebody is a Shogi nerd or a Shogi pro, they're like putting all those Shogi terminology in the normal conversation. Yeah, what a great move, Contetti. D35 says, I got my rating, but the crying face, I don't, is it a crying face or is it like the face with teeth like this? I wonder. Hopefully it's not the crying one, but it's good. You got your rating. That's good. Now we can improve it. I didn't walk. It was just haiku. Oh, I went for a nice walk outside earlier today to walk on Sundays. There's too many repetition. There is to walk in it. So I believe that that makes it invalid as a good haiku. Stroll outside. Stroll. Yeah, I went for a nice stroll outside earlier today to walk on Sundays. But that, where's the punchline? Yeah, we need the punchline now. Absolutely sobbing and devastated. No, no, it's a starting line. It's a starting line. I was also a very low rated player once, you know. Lies. I played chess. I won my first Shogi game. Lies. Everybody starts somewhere. I lost my chess game by a dump, like the fool's mate. So I got my roast there on my first tournament. I cried, went home. I was there, just on a different game. Ion, I don't like your gold move. Yeah, but we're trying to improve it, really. There was this famous Japanese program where there are like those idols competing for like different stuff like ikebana, so like flower arrangement, haiku, some word guessing, and there's like this very roasty teacher, and she has like this marker, like this red marker, and what they do is they first like read it out loud, na 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 na, and they read it twice always. And then everybody's like, whoa. And then she's like with the marker, and they put this like sound effect like when she crosses, she often like crosses out big parts of the text, and she like writes, this would be so much better. And everybody's like, oh, sensei, you're so right. And like, it's a stupid program, but I love it. We don't like your gold move either. Neither. The instant I move it, I thought, wait, I don't think I was supposed to do that. Yeah. Habits are bad. Sometimes habits are bad. Habit of thinking before playing a move, that's a good habit to have. Play moving the guard without thinking, that's a bad habit to have. What is this show? I don't famous Japanese shows. Let's see. I know, sorry, Ion. TV shows, I don't know what to do. But this is like One Piece, that's not what we're going for, right? Keep on observation around. Why did you come to Japan? That's a good one. Tiding with Marie Kondo. But that's English ones, right? But yeah, it's in Japanese, so... Can I come to your house? That's a fun one. Big anybody knows? Japanese show with idols, haiku, ikebana. Let's see that. Oh, this one. Yeah, that's the one. Just type what you want in Google, yeah? Pressure battle. Is it this one? Pressure battle. Yeah, that one. Pressure battle. Pure battle. Pure battle. Because in Japanese you take two words and you stick them together. So it's pressure, battle, pre-battle. I don't know, maybe there will be some videos we can show. Those are all famous idols. This is it's some explanation video. Yeah, I guess you would have to watch it actually. Those are all like trailers. So this one they paint actually. Yeah, it's fun. I think this is the haiku sensei, right? I hate to say it, but she got older. From what I remember, she has white hair now. But I think this is the haiku sensei. She's great. Haiku battle right now? Oh no. Let me see. We roast on Sundays, penguin chinchilla gen, life is so unfortunate. You're supposed to use complex words in haiku. Like seasonal arts or something. Can we find anything that's like showing the actual like haiku? Or is it all? Yeah, I'm afraid we cannot watch it. I wanted to show you guys this marker thing. Anyway, yeah, unfortunately they don't have it. Complex words like unfortunate. Maybe there is some beauty in using new word, maybe. I'm not a haiku teacher after all. Aren't we supposed to compose haiku in Japanese to begin with? I mean, there are different types of haiku. Up again. Alright. Oh my, we should do more of those breaks for random stuff. I feel so relaxed now. Yeah, so now we have this weakness, but maybe it's manageable. Our opponent has a very, very, very solid shape though. We will have to take that into consideration. Yeah, that's a losing shape, I think. What the heck is your opponent? How strong is he? Pretty done. Don't believe it. Yes, so you can expect him to push this next, right? Maybe something like this. Isn't it like better? I don't know. Unfortunate forge. That's a very interesting haiku, Lily. It is scary, but they cannot drop the pawn, so that's... it's scarier for them to have the silver hanging like this. So if you do this, that's kind of nice for them. And they can drop the pawn here, right? Or even here. And basically your castle is over. Yeah, it doesn't exist anymore. King had to go away. The only way to deal with this situation is putting pressure on this bishop, but it's quite hard, right? If you put your silver here, he's going to come here. Yeah. And now they just build up the pressure. They built a castle in front of your castle, yeah? You're defending pretty well, though. So the problem you have is this silver is useless. All of those pieces are putting the pressure, right? It's called a pressure play. I don't know how to explain it better. Okay, Kent. Good night. I will keep it for the next week then. Thank you so much. Your opponent is in a free down. I don't think he is a free down. The pawn sack was to try to change the scene of the fight. Yeah. Yeah, so once your king is pressured like this, it's really hard to like overturn it. That's my experience. I don't exactly know how to deal with it properly. But just this position, yeah? His silver is on the 5th rank and his opponent on the 6th rank. That means he's winning. Right? We all know this. So from now on, just, is he going to win or not? Dark Tommy says, I'm quite new on the stream and wondered what are the Kifu analysis primary goal? Well, you bring your Kifu, your game, we look at it, we give you advice, and you're gonna improve. That's the goal. In the meantime, people who watch, they might input their own comments. They also might learn something by watching. I'm not gonna lie, it's something I perhaps was inspired by those chess YouTubers or like Overwatch streamers. They also like look at Overwatch game and they are like, this is what you should do. And turns out many people like to have their game reviewed. They struggle with answer, like what they're doing wrong. And us having not many English materials, I think that's important, yeah. Well, yeah, that's the goal. The big goal and the small goal. And we can get roasted, yes. You can ask for extra spicy analysis. All right. So I think the point is strategically. And maybe we can take this position and bring it to computer sensei. Did you actually write? No. You didn't write about it, okay. I should be logging into everything before stream starts. I keep wasting time on it. Okay, that's not too bad. Let's take a look at this position in particular. This one, right? So this is minus 111. This is so close. So it wasn't the worst. But the bishop drop. Still not bad. This is all a computer move, by the way. Oh my god, this all is a computer move. So you are fighting well here. I thought maybe, like, practically speaking, it's difficult to win. So let's see this move. I was curious. It's gonna be like, it's super bad. Okay, it's not too bad. Apparently they're gonna attack on the edge. But it's still close. Here the computer was saying to push this pawn in front of the bishop too, but that brings us the question. You hate computer. Yeah. So, like, humanly speaking, I would prefer to disturb the enemy silver. Oh, you can allow them to promote. That's crazy. All right. Pawn takes and then exchange. They drop, we take. Silver drop 6-2. God goes back, and then you move the rook. Interesting. No, you don't think about. I'm just considering the options, yeah? I'm not thinking, oh, this is better because there are 66 points more or less. I'm just happy that it didn't say that it's a total blunder. I was just making sure that what I told you, like, I would consider this. Computer senses says, yeah, it's not too bad. And that's what it said, so that was an option, yeah? I personally didn't like to have this position. But the way we should look at it, again, according to computer sensei, is to put a pressure on this bishop as soon as possible. That's an important hint we've gotten. We may hate or dislike, like or dislike computers, but what we talked about before is now confirmed, yeah? Now we can go all over it. Hi, Koshiro! Did you consider going for a rapid attack with a light castle? So, like, here, right? I honestly, like, seeing the opponent has four pieces in defense like this, I wouldn't be too optimistic about it, but maybe Koshiro is right. Maybe that's one way to go for it. The opening is like this. So maybe keeping the gold on the bottom. And then, yeah. But we talked about the gold being a little bit a mistake, overplay too early type of deal. Yeah. Ion agreed that he played it too quickly, basically. Yeah, so that's the point, yeah, Koshiro, yeah. I agree. I don't remember the way he played, actually. Like this, okay. So. Oh, he didn't push the edge, actually. So maybe like this, maybe like this, but then we still don't have an attack, right? He waited, yeah. instead of, yeah. Let's take a look, quick look on this graph. So this is where computer wanted you to attack. But yeah, generally speaking, this up to here, it's not bad. And then it went south. Unfortunately, from now on, it's like tactical, yeah. The bishop that you liked actually seems to give them an advantage, unfortunately. Going for rook activation is what they want. This is the move where the computer said, like, pound push. Which is clearly saying, like, oh, they took this vanguard pawn. We don't care. We have many defenders here. What we care about is having, like, a counterattack. Because if we go strongly, they actually have only god next to the king. So going for counterattack makes sense in this position, yeah? My problem is I don't really know what to do after this move. Yeah. It's again the computer play, right? Pawn push, does it work? Bishop takes, we go in, type of deal. The rook exchange really is scary to us as well, so it's not super clear. Silver takes after, but it's their move, right? Oh, it was here, rather. Oh, pound drop 7-3, that's an option. Pound drop 7-3. Something like this is a way to, like, delete that vanguard pawn. Probably gold takes from the bottom. Bishop takes. But that's... We're doing this is so complex. This is, I'm not gonna lie, very, very complex. Even the computer is like showing different options. Let me see. Even here it says bishop activation. Yeah, that's, I think that's what you meant, right? Or yeah, I don't know. Bishop activation is your main thing to do here. And the question is, what if they defend, right? With the rook. Yeah, enemy's castle is thin indeed. It's a crazy battle. It's a kind of weird shogi because you cannot really go for the tabaki. The rooks are pinned to each other. The bishops are just staring at each other. The main players in this opening are the generals, right? The fight of who's gonna take the important point, who will perhaps sabaki their bishop, right? That's all will matter here. And yeah, we have to notice, yeah, their king is quite weak. So once we have, for example, a pawn here, this would enable us to drop a silver here somewhere in the future, would enable us to put a pressure on this king. You did a good job, like moving away from the pressure your opponent is putting on your king. But it's a very, very close fight. And then, knowing that, do we play this move or do we play this move? Yeah. I think, even though the computer doesn't agree with me, I think allowing them to go to the fifth row like this is quite scary. I wonder if you can drop the pawn here. Like, if they take here, the silver is quite dead, so I know the overlay. I just curious. Curiosity. Can you drop the pawn here or not? They take the 8-4. They might like go for the edge attack. I'm just curious. Yeah, they would take it. Bishop drop, pawn drop, knight. Okay. They would go for the edge attack. Is it less scary? Koshiro, is this less scary than this? What do you think? Humanly wise, yes. So silver you can target next, right? Silver that you can oppose your own silver against. And you have this pawn. You have Hasami on the silver. So just at a glance, it looks very unpleasant for your opponent. Of course, because it's computer, you know, they're gonna play there and so on and so on. But yeah, not easy to spot, yeah. You said yourself you don't like computers, so humanly speaking. Just out of curiosity, I wanna check something. It's got it right. Ah, one more move the computer is proposing, guys. Here, silver move. It's also a really nice move, isn't it? Not allowing the silver to come to the center. I think it's the most solid one. instead of taking, you put more pressure. And this time, if they were to take, take, drop here, this time it's on the fifth row as compared to the sixth row, right? That should be a little bit better. I mean, it's still pretty unpleasant, but a little bit better, perhaps. Out of curiosity. If they drop the pawn. It's equal. Go here, they go here, we create a castle. And then continue, yeah? But yeah, this is some play that you don't see often in Europe. Around here. It's called pressure play. It's a different type of shogi that I also recommend you guys to look into. Well, it's a question whenever you prefer this position or the previous position, yeah? I'm perhaps concerned about this attack here that they did on the head of the goat. Yeah, the bishop was great. It reminds me what Shimizu played against me in the last My Navi game. She also did some attack like this. Yeah, here we would like to drop the pawn, actually, but we cannot because of this, right? So here we cannot do this because of this. So instead of taking it, let's defend beforehand. Yeah. They're gonna take the vanguard pawn. That's their right. It's their right because we were a little bit behind here. It's their right to do so. If we had this shape already, here, we would be able to defend, right? But we were one move behind. Maybe because we played this move. Like, we could consider it's deeper as opening theory. How can I get a counterplay after my opponent gets a vanguard pawn? Well, you have a pawn in hand, so you could use it somewhere else. If you wanted to, you could activate the knight somewhat. What they would try to do is to exchange the 6-5 pawn, right? They will maybe they will go like silver back, plus pawn push. Maybe they will push here. They will be playing very slowly. Questions, how do we counter it? Do we go for quick attack? Or do we also fight with the pressure? Moves like pawn drop 7-3, I don't like personally. Bishop drop to 4-6 is the biggest concern. Here we had one example, rook 4-2, right? Rook 6-2, lands up, rook 4-2. Great, thank you, computer. So, I guess, like, activating the rook. What they're saying is, I'm just gonna play it one move faster. I don't know why they did it. But basically, because they have four generals on this side, it means they will have trouble defending this side, right? So we will be able to break through. Because they have points on this side, we should take points on that side. That's one way. Exactly, computer. Well, he has probably some form of reasoning, but I'm not gonna get into it today. Yeah, very light. It's because, you know, they have the silver here. It usually sits here to help defending. Again, freestyle shogi, we notice the difference and we try to capitalize on it. Yeah, it connects to the first game we analyzed today a little bit. We, of course, have this big problem with the silver. But then we come back to the opening with the question about the gold, right? About this choice. Especially that we see them play solid. What is the type of play we would like to do here? Is the bishop exchange we would like to go for or not? Yeah. If we go for the bishop exchange, where do we put the gold? This is what should go through our mind. What is our game plan? Do we have time to play h-pawn, yeah? Do we compete for this square or do we allow them to take the vanguard pawn, yeah? Those are the things we have to make choice here. Instant regret, yeah. Well, but yeah, there are many things we could have done in this game, right? It's not like one thing was wrong. It's just that it's a particular opening we should get more experience in, yeah? I also hated to play against it when I was fully bishop player. Young, amateur, I hated it. I hated this vanguard shape that you mentioned, yeah? It's so cramped and bad. But yeah, we should capitalize on the other side. As an answer to that, perhaps. Alright, thanks, Ion. We're gonna go to Lily's game now. This was a teaching game, and I kept finding ways for Stade to break through. Though he didn't succeed in doing so in the end. Is there a general way to make it less than likely for Stade to have a good position? What happened with the homework, Lily? I remember still. I still remember the homework. Stade, I don't know how many it is to be. No problem, Ian. Thank you for sending. I feel like I don't have enough experience myself to answer it properly, but we thought about it together. We learned together something new, yeah? Thanks so much. Hi. Yeah, step by step. We cannot learn everything in one day. Yeah. Okay. The first thing that Stade could have done better, I guess. Not allow the token to be made. By the way, generally speaking, you don't want to put the silver here so quickly, Lily. Because as Wate, You would more happily put it here, toward the center. So the reason why we put it here is in answer to this move. Because then they can put up. So for example, the joseki, right? Joseki would be to push here and here. Put the rook here, exchange, put the rook back here. We then put this over here so that we can retake the pawn. There's no reason to put it there directly like that, I feel. Then, depending on the situation, maybe we can use it here. I don't know exactly, but maybe. Like, forbid them from using their bishop. Yeah, you just win here, right? That's a little bit painful. Didi and 3-5 silver comes back. 3-5 silver comes back, guys. I clearly remember analyzing another Kifu from Lily where that happened. Oh my god, and it worked. Okay. Okay, I guess it works, yeah. Can we do anything against it? Pound push, super dicks. Now it's in the weirdest spot, but their token exists and we don't like the token. We probably don't want to take that pawn. Oh, that's a good move again. Yeah, sure. But our king, we don't have to play this move. Our king's head is a little bit concerned right now, not gonna lie. Pawn drop. Really nice move to do, right? Cannot be taken. I mean, it doesn't mean it's a win, but go back. Pawn drop. Put more pressure. Okay, the silver comes in. Yeah, this is similar to what we had in Neon game. In a handicap game, you don't have big pieces. You have to utilize the general as well. And you all probably, guys, we all know this feeling. Like those enemy generals climbed next to our king, building the castle in front of our face. That's the worst feeling in the world. All right. Lily, I don't know what to tell you exactly. Apart from the silver thing. Who are you playing against in general? Blake, okay, so the new member of our Discord, right? He wanted to play super aggressive, so I thought it might be interesting early. Yeah, but if you want to play super aggressive, why not use the silver in the center, yeah, you know? Even more aggressive than just putting it there, yeah? Using all your pieces. Welcome back, Contetti. To be aggressive, you need pieces, you need resources, right? Alright, thanks for uploading this. I assume you did it for the... actually, for the study to like watch it and maybe learn from it. So thanks for doing that, yeah? And teaching new players. Alright, Valorant. Let's go. A blunder resulting in failure of a very strong attack. Time trouble on both sides helped me secure this one with dragon sacrifice. Which I'm not so sure was that sound. Well, let's find out. In the meantime, I'm gonna refresh. We have two more after that, Abigail and Kent. Kent said he wanna do it later for Abigail. We're gonna see if we have time for it or not. Got there, yeah. That's a Japanese name. How strong? Two down. All right. Has Lily tried correspondence games that might help with your homework? Yeah, that could help, yeah. I mean, I tended to play correspondence very quickly as well, but yeah. Yeah, this is why I recommended you playing long time game. Especially if you're trying to get attorney to king, they use longer time limit, right? Would be nice practice for it. Oh no, is it the pressure play again? It's a weird shape, not gonna lie. Usually you would put the gold, the king here, the gold here, and this gold would climb there. That would be more natural. And this could evolve into vanguard pawn easily. Yeah, so I'm thinking about bishop drop or like a gold slowly climbing there, but we have to be aware enemy has a bishop in hand, they can start attacking anytime, yeah? So it's a little bit timing based. Thank you, Tommy. See you next time. Remember we have the Discord as well, so. You can always put it in the Kifu form and I'm gonna see it next week, even if you're not here. We can analyze it. Okay, I see. So you're going for swinging rook. Your castle is inexistent. This is a cool move. But our silver dice. Take the knight, all right. Ooh. That would be good, but our king is kind of weak. So, if this king would be here in a castle, I wouldn't mind. It's just that it's kind of weak. Sure. Yeah, the knight comes in. Punish the knight. Drop the knight in front of the pawn. Amazing. Oh, isn't this a little bit overplay? I mean, taking lands seems solid. Going here, yeah, take the bishop. Wait. Oh, the double rook attack. I like it. I like it, but we're missing pieces. I like it, but we're missing pieces. And now the opponent is attacking, and what we're gonna do about it, yeah? It's gonna be a problem. Valorant, you're getting quite strong quite quickly. Nice. Your idea was to play freestyle again. Sure, let's go with that. This pawn drop is a nice way to like go for it. You found this nice tsuji. If the rook takes, there's this bishop, which kind of complicates life for Sente. Really nice. Going for the knight, capturing the rook. But I want you to notice that your king isn't exactly safe, and there were times where it was under fire. And probably with stronger opponent, it shouldn't have survived, yeah? So remember there's a risk to this opening. There's probably some safer ways to go for it. Just like you don't have to move the king all the way. You can be more sneaky about it, perhaps. Now the question is, do you really need to move this pawn twice? You can keep it here and again go for like silver crown. It's called feigning rook, I think it's called the opening. I'm going here. Yeah, the could we have omitted those two moves, you know? Could we have just played the pawn, gold, rook? And then, you know, our king would be a little bit further away from the battle. Yeah, something we could consider. Little bit too close. Now, where do we attack? We go here. Again, this is our defensive knight, yeah? Why not take those two pieces for ourselves? Or take this knight for ourselves? We don't wanna lose the defensive power here, right? We should be concerned about this move a little bit too, but the way I see it, I drop a pawn, I take this knight, I drop it here. Then I need one more pawn. One more pawn. My idea is if they come here, I just move my server up, I'm fine. But then they maybe attack here. So it's a big deal for us to get rid of this knight as soon as possible, perhaps. They go here, it's going away from the king. Maybe you can utilize on it. And then like break through. If we had one more pawn, it would be easy, but we're missing that one pawn. Rook sacrifice? This is gonna work. King takes probably, yeah. But you see the difference, yeah? We're attacking with this knight instead of this knight. Making our king safer while having more pieces to use, yeah? Here, yes. We ended up sacrificing one of the knights while giving them tempo, yeah? And weakening our king. Pawn takes also looks like a really strong move here, in general. Knight promotion next is just scary. Look, you cannot take it with neither of the generals. It's just terrifying. Pawn drop. Promotion takes, takes. And we kind of arrived at the similar position from before, but this time we have two pawns in hand. This time we can drag the king out of the castle, yeah? Maybe drop another one. Maybe drop the bishop behind. Something like this, yeah? Really nice way to break it. Instead of using a piece again, taking from your opponent is important. Do not run away out of attacking pieces, yeah? We have the sacrifice part polished, but we need the sustain part on, yeah? Little bit more here. It's slow, yeah, it's slower. It doesn't attack the gold, but hey. We admit our king is safe enough. We go for the win. one move slower, perhaps. Maybe not as aggressive. It is actually quite aggressive, but maybe not the same excitement, not the same feeling. Still a good move. Still the better move. Yeah. Because here we're out of pieces. And here, totally out of pieces. Could we have done something better here? Again, we're dropping, sacrificing a lot, yeah. And you could probably feel during the game a little bit rough, yeah, the horse is here protecting. Yeah, probably still winning, but not the same power is behind it. So this is where it matters. Apart from that, amazing. Well, nice idea. Yeah, just the king position. This pawn was the most amazing pawn of the game, though. I have to admit, really well done. What is your rating now? Shodan. Yeah, climbing. Nicely done, Valorant. Thank you for sending it. Okay, Kent's gonna be next week because he wanted. And we have Abigail that's gonna be the last one, Shogi extended. I tried a new formation in I3 Bishop against a pretty strong opponent, Tudan. I think I misplayed the engage. Maybe 3-3 pawn 7-5 instead of knight takes 6-5. And I ended up playing moves that were not so effective. I want to see if Karolina Sensei can find an effective continuation. Let's see if Karolina Sensei can do it. Brave king indeed. Alright, but I don't know who's center. I mean, I don't see the dame who's Abigail. Abigail, you're there? Abigail! Are you top or bottom? The ping pong sound. Fix it. How do I fix the ping pong sound? Oh, here it says. Abigail to Q, center. All right. Center. All right. Wait, what did I ask? What did I do? Oh my god, sleeping bird. What did I do? No. What did I say? Did I say something? Okay, we're gonna, guys, I'm sorry. We will have the, unless I mute the page. Mute site. Ah, much better. Okay, new shape. All right. I never played it myself. I'm quite curious. Bishop exchange. Knight comes in. Interesting. Feels nice, yeah? Feels nice to have this. Piece activated. Do you want to drop the bishop first or not? Do you want to sacrifice the piece or not? The pawn first or not? If we sacrifice the pawn, silver takes, it's a bishop drop. If pound push, pawn takes. When we jump the knight, silver escapes. We can run with the rook, right? We're gonna drop the bishop. Never drop the bishop, we take, drop it again. Drop it behind. We make a horse, we win. Ah, here, 7-5. Okay, 7-5. They might not take it or take it. If they take, we take, they run. Maybe we can sacrifice the rook. Maybe we can drop a pawn, exchange the knights. Yeah, definitely this position is quite important. We wanna not simply jump, we wanna add some more spice to it. Yeah, we're cooking, Shogi cooking. How do we roast our opponent the best? Okay, so you went for this pawn exchange, yeah? So yeah, so the reason why I was considering the bishop, because here, let's say they defended with the knight and the silver is here. Here. Ah, oh, but the silver will be here. Okay. My idea was to sacrifice it, gold takes and promote the knight, but if the silver is here, it kind of breaks the purpose. Yeah, that cannot be. Drop that bishop here. Is it an option? Maybe drop it here. Pressure play. Yeah. No, Abigail. I was thinking about the knight promotion here. But bishop drop, knight takes bishop drop, silver up. Unfortunately, the silver up defends both the knight and the center. So my idea of sacrificing the bishop doesn't work because of it. Ah, you eventually did drop it. Okay. Oh, here. Okay. Okay, I see. Oh! No! Bishop takes the silver. Gold retakes. Silver drop. No? They push. We take. They take. We promote. No? Is it. Yeah. That would activate your bishop nicely. This is why you drop it in the first place, yeah? To break the Anaguma. This pawn push will block your bishop while you give the tempo to the enemy. So it's very unfortunate. We're missing the spies here, yeah? We did activate the knight, but we have no punch to it. And now we're struggling, we're panicking because we don't have enough. We lost the knight. This move isn't the best, maybe. Maybe it is. And the opponent has the initiative. But they mess up. Then we counter, we broke the rook, we go for talking. Barely survive. And then we lose some time. Yeah, so that was crucial. I recommend Abigail. This is time usage, right? Not the computer. I recommend you study this position, right? Study here. He walked into this line. Maybe we could have exposed it somehow, especially the rook is on the same line. Feels right to like abuse the king positioning, right? Yeah, the bishop is nice because then we have four pieces in attack: rook, knight, silver, bishop, yeah. And their rook and their silver isn't activated, therefore it feels really nice. Even if our attack wouldn't be the best, at least we were the one with the attack and they won't have one. Yeah, but I'm happy to hear, Abigail, that you're playing against two Dan Shogi Wars. You know, the two Dan Shogi Wars is gonna be stronger than the normal two Dan, so quite a nice fight here. I'm glad to see your game again. And you try new shape, yeah? I love to see it. Yeah, this is a very aggressive shape. This is what top lady pro are playing nowadays. I should study it myself. Really cool to see it in your fight. Okay, Koshiro is saying, how about bishop 5-5? And then 7-5 and 8-4. Okay, so you're combining all of those moves. Yeah. But again, maybe bishop. Maybe takes. Maybe knight takes. Maybe bishop. Let's ignore the fact that we can make a horse. Yeah, let's say they're stubborn. And then you're saying 7-5 first. Say they take. Let's say they take. And now here. So my question is, how do we continue attacking exactly, yeah? Oh, here. That would be nice. This is the Yagura. One tricky way to learn playing against Aifuribisha Yagura, the right side Yagura, is to check the normal Yagura Joseki. Because, stupidly enough, this is the same shape, it just mirrored. So the same test suji will work. So this test suji that Koshiro is pointing out is where we force this pawn to be pushed, allowing us for the crossing rook. So it's a very beautiful line. And this is quite unstoppable if you look at it. Pawn drop, rook sack. And now we attack both king and 5-3 square. And I cannot drop the pawn because the pawn is here. Very, very powerful tactic here. Thank you, Koshiro, for pointing it out, yeah? I will just show like one line, just for example. Maybe we grab the silver here. If they go here, we take and drop two gods. Yeah, that would be a mate. Unfortunately, it deleted everything, but you get the idea, yeah? Yagura Jasuki. Let's try to see this one again. So let's say it benefits us to get the knight here. And then instead they're gonna do this. We take, take, bishop drop here. It looks also nice, eh? We get a horse. I wouldn't mind, yeah, put a horse here or something. If they move the silver to protect it, we can always like exchange it. We can go slowly here, eat up those pawns, get some pawns, and then attack stronger. They can attack here, and but we can jump, so maybe it's a good fight, yeah? And then the horse is beautifully strong here. Also, this knight is hanging, so we could have taken it. Yeah, the horse would be very, very strong. Yeah. So yeah, this is, we call this too simple. That's what I would say. Tanjun sugir. Too simple. Make it stronger. Make your knights feel supported. Yeah, again. All right, guys. It's 7 now. I have to go for dinner. I had pleasure analyzing your games. Let me see if I missed someone. So we will have Kent next week. We will have Ko on YouTube. We will have two more games waiting for us. I should really start doing it. I'm lazy thing. All right, yeah, but you're gonna see some YouTube videos next week. I'm gonna work on it. And yeah, I'm gonna see you guys on Discord. Thank you for coming. Lily, please do your homework. And see you on Thursday, yeah? Bye-bye. Thank you, Abigail, for the 200 bits.